Hi, this tutorial will guide you on how you can build a basic neurofeedback pipeline and later how you can control a Raspberry car and a computer game. For today, we are using the OpenBCI 8-channel amplifier. So we can use this as a EEG, EMG or ECG amplifier. And for the electrodes, I am using the iodine electrodes, iodine diodes. So these are very soft and we don't require any gel to use this. And we are using the snap cable connectors to connect the OpenBCI board and the electrodes. So here I will show you how to create the neurofeedback pipeline. So first open the Neuromore Studio. Right click and create new file called neurofeedback and click OK. Now open the newly created pipeline. So we have to first get the data from the OpenBCI board. So we'll use something called open sound control. So just drag two inputs, OS input from the input tab, as we are using two electrodes, FP1, FP2. So change the address of first node to /openbci/fp1 and change the sampling rate to 250 to match the Cyton sampling rate. Now change the second node address to openbci/fp2 and similarly change the sampling rate of 250. Yeah, now we get two channel data, so we have to merge this. Go to utilities tab and select the merge channel and connect the OSC output to the input of merge channels. So next go click on NM Studio, settings, devices. So let the host IP, target host IP be 127.0.0.1, that is our local computer, and close it, save this. Now go to the DSP tab and get the IIR filter, connect the output of merge channel to the IIR filter. Next you have to connect the FFT node. So the OpenBCI signals are in time domain. We have to convert them into frequency domain to do further operations. So we'll connect to FFT. So before that, we'll change the IIR filter setting. So we'll change the filter type to band pass and change the lower cutoff frequency to 2 and higher cutoff to 45. This will help us remove any line frequency noise. Then we have to select the frequency band. We'll go to the DSP again and we'll select the frequency band, and as we are showing the demo in beta, so I'll select the band to beta, but you can select to anything. It can be theta, alpha, beta, it is on your personal preference. So let's use beta here. So connect the output of FFT to the frequency band. So next we have to go to the utils tab and select the channels. So we have to perform operations on both the channels, that is FP1 and FP2. So we'll select the channels individually so we can address them. So select the output, set the output of frequency band and connect it to the select channels. And as you can see, now we can see the FP1 and FP2 over here. So now we have to do operation. We'll have to do average of the both the channel. So now select operation and change the map function to average. Now connect these two channel to X and Y. So now we are getting the average value. Now connect a statistics tab. This will help us find the mean, so the output will be smoother. So now to view the signals, go to output and drag the view and connect the statistics to the input of the view and select the OSC output and drag it to the pipeline and connect the statistics node to the OSC. So whatever data we get, the neurofeedback value, we can send it to an address, so we can either receive this in a Raspberry Pi or a local computer. So later we can use this to find our neurofeedback threshold value. Change, increase or decrease the neurofeedback value depending upon our average threshold value what we have got in 4.8. So sometimes it may work for this, sometimes if you want to increase the difficulty, we'll have to increase this, or if you want to reduce the difficulty, we'll have to decrease this. So I'll show you a pipeline how we can do this. So drag in two parameter. So for example, let this be the beta average value. So I'll take it as 10 for example. Yes. And now change this to increase by percent. Increase by percent. So don't forget to change the sample rate to 50, because we have to match all the sampling frequency to the Cytron board. So now, like if I change the value here, suppose I change the value by 10, so this means I want an increase of feedback by 10%. So I'll go to math and I'll drag the operation and change the math function as divide. So divide the second value by 100. Okay, connect the increase percentage to the x. So now drag another operation. So change the name as multiplier, and even change this as divide, so it will be better for understanding. So now change the math function to multiply. Now connect the beta average value and the divide. So now you'll have to add another operation, that is add. Now we have to add both signals what we get. So connect the multiplier output and the average signal. So now close this, add a signal view. So I'm drag to outputs. Yes. Now connect the beta average, this is 10, so this is 2. So as you can see, you're getting 11 here, so that is a 10% increase. Now if you change the beta value, that is 30, so 10% increase, that is 33, so you're getting the value of 33 in here. So this is how you increase. Suppose you want to decrease this, all you have to do is change this to subtract. So now what happens, instead of adding, it will subtract. You can change this to decrease by percent. Yes. Now save it. So what's happening is 3 is being deducted. So by this you can change the difficulty of your neurofeedback. So next I'll show you how you can integrate this to visualization, so that we can play a computer car game using the beta feedback what we got, and we can change and change the parameters by using this pipeline. So now I'll show you how to control the cartoon game using our neurofeedback. So start streaming the data and start streaming through LSL, and run this script again to stream the data to the Neuromo Studio. So as you can see, you are getting electrode 1 and electrode 2 data here. So now go to the backend file system and scroll to the bottom part and right click on visual test and copy to personal folders. Okay. Yeah, we do have visualization test copy over here. So let us configure this to control this using our neurofeedback pipeline. So just drag it out of the way. So just start creating the neurofeedback pipeline as I mentioned it to you before. So now, in addition, we have to add a compare node, so that we can compare the value what we get right now in the real time and the feedback what we have calculated. So go to the math tab and open compare. So let's just move this out of the way. make sure not to remove any connections. So right now let's include the pipeline from which we can change the neurofeedback value. Output of statistic to compare node X input and connect the output of add node. The movement speed is now connected to speed hover here. So this parameter actually detects how speed the car moves. So let's just delete the parameter here. And instead of that, let's connect our output . So before that, we'll have to remap the signal. So go to math and remap. So I want to connect this, I want to remap it. So input min, I have to change to input max. I have to see the maximum, that is 5.9. So I'll write here input max is 5.9. And the scale, it'll scale the data to 0 to 1. So this is how the feedback will work, the car speed. So now connect the remap output to the movement speed node and again connect the session points. So delete this connection. So connect this output to session. So whenever you get a feedback value, you will be adding points, so you can understand. So now connect the compare output to the remap. So you have to change the setting for the compare. So whenever the signal X is greater than Y, it has to pass the X signal. So true return mode, that is return X. So whenever the condition is true, it will send the signal. Before we start playing the game, let us calculate the threshold values again. So go to your pipeline and now just add in a OSC output so that we can stream it to the script. Connect the statistic output to the OSC output and give the addresses out.data. Now save this. You can go ahead and add the signal view. And now just run the script on your computer. So let me fast forward my video. So the average feedback value to be set is 2.4. So let me add in here 2.4. So let it be just 1. So as you can see here, whenever it goes above 2.8, the threshold value, there will be activation of signal. So I have to input the maximum beta here, that is 4.3, and minimum is 1.3. And you can just clamp the output. So if the signal goes above 4, you can just ignore it. So like no other sudden movements can actually induce the movement of the car. So save it. So now click on this. Select the cartoon down. Play. Now click on go to start the game. So as you can see, my real time beta value went above the threshold. So it can be anything, I'm just talking right now, so it will increase my concentration level. So what I can do otherwise is I can just decrease the feedback value. So let me just decrease it by 10% and save it. So it will be much easier for me to play the game. Like if I want to increase the difficulty, I can just add the increase by percent, and instead of subtract, I can just do addition to the signals. Now I will show you how we can use the neurofeedback to control a Raspberry car. So start by starting the OpenBCS stream and go to the settings to the network. Now enter your local computer IP address, that is 127.0.0.1. So now start to run the code to send the data from OpenBCI GUI to the NeuroMore Studio. So now we'll start the training of data, collection of data. So let me fast forward the video. Okay, now as you can see, we have got the average value. So now I'll open the pipeline for Raspberry Pi. Now go to settings and again be sure to enter your Raspberry Pi IP address or the target IP, and be sure to set the UDP port to 12345. So now run the script on the Raspberry Pi. So I'm connecting the battery. So as you can see in the studio, whenever my beta feedback goes back above the threshold, so the car is activated accordingly. So now I'll show you how I run the cartoon game. So open the visualization pipeline. And type in the average value, what you got in the console.